Welcome back, East Asia Super League fans. I'm your host, Boom Gonzalez. Good to see everyone again, and you're watching Full Court Press, your number one source for the top basketball headlines this side of the Pacific. Let's begin over at the PBA. A referee and a Blackwater player tested positive for COVID-19. Now, both have been isolated and both have yielded negative results after getting retested. The PBA has decided to postpone two games as a preventive measure and are taking necessary steps to make sure the bubble will not be compromised. The PBA now has five players averaging at least 20 points. Matthew Wright, Jamar Perez, Roger Pogoy, Bobby Ray Parks, and Kiefer Ravenna. No player from one of the top teams, Ginebra, is averaging 20. Roger Pogoy has looked absolutely unstoppable, leading TNT to the top of the standings. The three-time PBA All-Star is on a mission and is putting up major numbers, just like back in the terrific 12 a year ago. Following a 15-month suspension, Calvin the Beast Abueva has been reinstated by the league. The Phoenix Fuel Masters are excited to have Abueva back in the fold. Dubbed Manila Clasico, the most popular rivalry in the PBA, dealt Barangay Ginebra its first loss in five outings as it yielded to the Magnolia Hotshots 102-92. A telling 14-0 run in the penultimate quarter, including seven by Paul Lee, broke open the game that was close throughout. The newly acquired Jackson Corpus led the Hotshots with 20 points and 6 rebounds. Let's swing it over to China and the CBA. The next generation of Chinese basketball is in good hands. Young stars are emerging as new leaders Sun Minghui, Guo Ailun, Hu Jingqiu, Wang Zhelin, and Zhou Qi are all top 10 scorers in the league, averaging over 25 points per game, and none of them are older than 27. Talk about young guns. There's another guard you may have heard of, Gao Shuyan, the former backup of Guo Ailun in Liaoning. Now, he's with Shandong and looks like a man on a mission, averaging nearly 20 points and 6 assists. He previously helped Liaoning clinch the terrific 12 championship last year. For the Japanese B.League, there's been a lot of changes. They've adapted new import rules. Now, each team may now register 3 imports, up from 2 imports just a year ago. There's also an extra spot for a 4th import, provided he's from an Asian country. Enter 30 Ravenna. According to the league, roughly 60% of import players and a little less than 90% of non-Japanese staff signed with clubs have not been able to enter Japan. The B-League has also shifted format this year, increasing the total team pool to 20 and going from 3 6-team conferences to 2 conferences of 10 teams. Strong teams have already repositioned and are taking advantage of the new rules, notably the Seahorses Mikawa. They re-signed Shunsuke Kashiwagi, a veteran leader and a guy who can change the locker room. Of course, the brick house Devontae Gardner doesn't hurt to have him on your team either, raking in over 20 points and 8 boards per game. Let's take it back over to the action in the SBL and the P-League. Now, last week it was the P-League holding exhibition games, and this time it was the SBL playing in the 2020 Molten Super Basketball Challenge. The tournament has 6 teams playing until November 1st to determine a winner. The P-League will also be playing more exhibition games coming up in early November, and then there's this familiar face coming in. Quincy Davis, the naturalized legend who won 4 championships in the SBL and became a naturalized citizen, has signed with the P-League team, the Taoyuan Air Apes. Congratulations, Uncle Q! Now let's take it back to Korea. The Incheon Electroland Elephants are still sitting pretty at the top of the standings, and we recently got a look at a powerhouse matchup against the Goyang Orion Orions. The Elephants won in a nail-biter, 73-71. The kid, Nakhyum Kim, came up clutch with a team-high and his career-high 19 points. The 25-year-old who was barely playing over 10 minutes 3 years ago has now become an elite guard in the league and is a big reason why the Elephants are the team to beat. Now, let's take a look at the top teams from around the region in our standings boards. Thanks for watching, everyone, and be sure to join us next time for more EASL Full Court Press. For more news and fresh content on YouTube, subscribe to East Asia Super League's YouTube channel and hit the notification bell for the top basketball headlines from around the region. And don't forget to follow East Asia Super League on all of our social media accounts. I'm your host. My name is Boom Gonzalez. Stay healthy and safe, and I'll see you soon.